Welcome to the fifth episode of Pipe Organs of NYC, a series of virtual organ tours sponsored by the New York City chapter of the American Guild of Organists. My name is James Wetzel, and I am the chapter's subdean and your host. In this episode, we visit two of the largest Protestant houses of worship in the city, Fifth Avenue Presbyterian Church and the Riverside Church, both of which have a long tradition of musical excellence. The congregation that is now named Fifth Avenue Presbyterian was founded in 1808 downtown on Cedar Street. Under the leadership of an Irishman, a Dr. John Hall, the congregation settled uptown to Fifth Avenue at 55th Street and erected its current Victorian Gothic edifice of red New Jersey sandstone in 1875 with Carl Pfeiffer as architect. Its 286-foot steeple made it the tallest building when capped, and still contains the original hand-wound clockworks. The rounded sanctuary with sloping floors seats 2,000 comfortably, and a parish house with an attractive chapel west on 55th Street was added in 1925. Previous organs for the congregation include a Jardim, moved and rebuilt from the previous building, an Odell, and several iterations of a Skinner. The present organ of four manuals was installed as Austin's Opus 2347 in 1961, and a new Goulding and Wood console dates from 2017. There is also a two-manual Austin from 1970 in Kirkland Chapel. Counting 17 senior pastors and numerous civic luminaries in its history, FAPC continues to flourish as a modern urban church, with a choir that offers a successful concert series in addition to its liturgical duties. The list of past musicians at this Cathedral of Presbyterianism reads like a who's who: Lowell Mason, Eugene Thayer, Harold Gleason, Linwood Farnham, Robert Baker, William Whitehead, and Dick Westenberg. Dr. Ryan Jackson has been the music director, the director of music and fine arts ministries since 2012. And Dr. Patrick Krieger has been the associate since 2015. The Riverside Church, seated at one of the highest points of the city, overlooks the Hudson River at 122nd Street, near Columbia University, the Union Theological Seminary, and the Manhattan School of Music. Designed in the French Gothic style, with a particular nod to Chartres Cathedral, by the renowned firm of Allen & Collins, construction began in 1927, and the first service was held on October 5th, 1930. The nave, vaulted with Guastavino tile, seats 2,000. The 20-story, 392-foot tower contains offices, meeting rooms, and, of course, the 74-bell Laura Spelman Rockefeller Memorial Carillon. The Carillon's 20-ton Borden bell is the largest tuned bell in the world. The tower also makes it the tallest church in the country. A seven-story south wing, dedicated to Martin Luther King, was added in 1959. The church was conceived by philanthropist, businessman, and Baptist John D. Rockefeller, Jr. The first minister, Dr. Harry Emerson Fosdick, came up from the First Presbyterian Church. An interdenominational congregation with a long history of social justice, Riverside is affiliated with both the American Baptist Church and the United Church of Christ. The Riverside organ is one of the largest in the world, designed in 1948 by Virgil Fox, then organist of the church. It was built by Aeolian Skinner. The organ was subsequently redesigned by succeeding organist Fred Swan and enlarged over a 30-year period by curator of organs Anthony Bufano. It currently comprises 149 stops, 207 ranks, and over 12,000 pipes, spread over 10 divisions divided between the chancel and the gallery. The main chancel console is of five manuals. Following Drs. John Walker and Timothy Smith, Christopher Johnson has been the music director and organist since 2009 and shares the bench with associate Christopher Cregan. We continue to appreciate the art of transcription in this video, and I would encourage you to visit episode 4, in which Frank Bridges' Adagio in E received another rendition on quite a different instrument illustrating the variety of organ building in this city and in this series. Thank you for joining us for this episode. Please do find us on Facebook and continue to visit us on our YouTube page for forthcoming videos in this series.